salt air and the rust on your door. I never needed anything more, or whispers of are you sure. Never have I ever before, but I can see us lost in the memory. August slipped away into a moment in time, 'cause it was never mine. And I can see us twisted in bedsheets. August slipped away like a bottle of wine, 'cause you were never mine. You're back beneath the sun, wishing I could write my name on it. Will you call when you're back at school? I remember thinking I had you, but I
Hi and welcome to my world of knit, dreams, wool and love. This episode will be about these two designs, these two patterns. The Scrappy Cardi looks like this, and the very popular Scrap Vest. I will talk about the yarn, yarn alternatives, knitting techniques, inspiration, and I will tell you a bit about my adventure where I found the yarn. But before I get started, I will make a short introduction about myself. I am Trine. In Danish, it's you say Trine, but Trine, yeah. I live here in Denmark, and I think you already have noticed that I'm not, yeah, I think my English is okay, but I will apologize for all the mistakes I will make in this episode, because I haven't been speaking English for a long time. So yeah. But I will try. I've decided I will do it anyway, because my Danish vlog, or whatever you call a thing like this, you know, it's only for Danish people. Danish is is a language that only Danish people do understand. Where if I do this in English, I so much hope that I can reach out to you guys in New Zealand, in Australia, in US, in England, in Ireland, everywhere. So welcome. I am a knitting designer. I am a lecturer. I do lectures about my knitting trips and stuff like that. I am a author. I've made a book. I made this around the world with my knitting needles. You can get that on saxo.com. Yes. I'm a coach, I'm a teacher, I'm a mom, I'm a lot of stuff. But yeah, but I will... I have a plan that I will do an episode where I tell you all about me and my story and my adventures and how I just jumped out in all my dreams, because that's what I'm doing. Well, let's get started. And I will tell you about the scrap vest and the scrappy cardigan. I did this design in the spring 2021, you know, when COVID-19 was all over the place and I was working at home. I was teaching online, so I had some more time to knit. There is a Danish designer called Lærke Bagger, a young one. I call her young because she's much young. She's much younger than me. And she made a really, I think, she made something like knit together or something like that. She had made a book, a big pink one. I don't have it with me here, but she has made a lovely book with the lovely designs, and she made all these knots. So she used scraps too. I was really inspired by her and combined with my favorite yarn, I think almost favorite, yeah, the best in the world. It's the mohair from Touch Yarns, wood from New Zealand. I just love this yarn. It's just, yeah, I have a love affair with this yarn. So the design appeared that spring in 21, so it's like 2 years ago, but it has developed kind of over the last 2 years. Mm. I will tell you short about the yarn first. In 2018, I traveled to New Zealand all by myself on my first knitting trip, and that's where the book is from. It's made out of from that trip, with patterns and stories and pictures and stuff like that, from my first knitting trip to New Zealand. And when I went to New Zealand, I traveled at the South Island. I stayed in it. I lived in a sleeper car, and I was just all by myself. It was just a wonderful trip, and I could tell you, I could talk about that trip for hours. I did a visit to the small town called Clyde, down south on the South Island. And in Clyde, the beautiful yarn company Touch Yarns is situated. They have a lot of different yarn qualities, but this one with the mohair, I just fell in love with that. It is 70% kit mohair, fine kit mohair, 20% merino wool and 10% wool binder. And the thing I so much love about this yarn is that it is 100% natural, because I have looked for some similar, you know, quality in the weight as a, or, you know, yeah, how thick or whatever you say. And I found some alternatives, like, and I will get back to that, like Cowgirl Blues, and there is also some Norwegian company who make Rauma Yarn, and that's lovely yarn too, but it's like there is some nylon in, like the wool binder, instead of the wool binder, it's like a nylon binder, I guess. But this is 100% natural, and I like this chunky, bulky, whatever you call it in English. You have this weight system. We don't use that much in Denmark. But that I can knit on needles like 6, 7, 8. It's like, then it, yeah, it's good for me. I'm not that patient, so it's good for me to just get on with it. When I visited Clyde back then in 2018, they had so many colors in this quality, like lovely, lovely colors, and there was a lot to choose between. And now the colors are, I don't think they might have 10 colors or something. And back then they had these colors that were speckled or like hand dyed. And now they only have solid colors. It's okay, because it's still just such lovely yarn. 100 grams, 210 meters in a bowl like that. When I met the yarn, it was like in these hanks or skeins. I don't know what you call it, but now it's in these bowls. Yes. This vest is made of two strands or two threads, like one mohair, like this, and then together with it's like a sock yarn, but I have chosen this from a Danish company called Camarose. Mm-hmm. She has made this ecologisk summer, organic summer wool. It's 70% wool and 30% cotton, and that's organic. So one strand of this and one strand of this. And then the sock yarn, or this summer wool, as she call it, it's the same all the way in the vest. In the vest, yeah. So when I knit the edges, the ribbing, like down here and in the armhole and in the neckline, I use these two. then you can't see the this, do we say following thread? We say that in Danish, following thread. Yeah. But you know what I mean. Then it disappears, you can say that. It's the same color, it's similar. But because you let this, I have continue using this white thread, sock yarn color, following thread, it makes these speckles when I change the colors in the mohair. Sorry. And this is a scrap vest. It is scraps. And some of the colors here, like the light blue and the pink, you can't get that anymore in the touch yarns. But if you have, you know, here in Denmark, the mohair combined with silk has been very, very popular, but it's very, very thin. It's like lace weight. But you can use, if you have some scraps in that quality, you can use 2, maybe 3 strands of that. And then you can make some stripes out of that. Yes. I have another version here. Maybe I should show you this. It's made in the charcoal color, in the charcoal. Yeah, it's really dark here, but you can see it's like a charcoal mohair. I have a bit left here. And with a charcoal sock yarn together with that, you can't see it in the ribbing. But when I knit up here, and I've really used scraps here, you can see just 1 round, 2 rounds, 1 round. Then you can see the speckles with the following charcoal thread, strand, whatever. Yes, and when I use all these scraps, so I only make 1 round and a half a round, I do that, I just knit, like if I have a small, like this, I just knit until I've got, I don't know, 15 centimeters left, then I take a new one. And do like this. So when I have only got like this left, I just take my new thread and then I put them together like this. I don't do anything else. I just put them together and then I knit like 4, 5 stitches, and they are very thick. And when you get around to that part again, it's like really thick stitches, but it doesn't matter when you knit a chunky vest like this, you can't see it. So that's really, then you can use all your scraps. That's smart. Yes. The touch yarns, you can't get that in Denmark. I don't think you can get it here in Europe at all. I have imported this yarn. I haven't got much left, but I haven't got much left. I'm sorry. But when I do lectures about my knitting trips, I have got the yarn with me, and so I could sell some yarn. But it's quite expensive. The shipping is totally like really, really expensive when I get the yarn shipped from New Zealand to Denmark. So I will take a break importing the yarn. And that's a bit sad because I just so much love the yarn. But you can order it online. If you are here in Europe, be aware of taxes and all that, because if you if you purchase yarn for an amount like over 1,000 Danish crowns, it's like if you say in euro, it's like 150 euros, something like that, they will get some extra taxes on, so be aware of that. Yeah, but then I've been looking for some yarn in the same quality, so you can use that for my patterns. And as I mentioned before, the cowgirl blues are really, they are quite nice. They do both solid colors and they do the more hand-dyed colors. They have really nice yarn. It's not 100% natural. It's 78% mohair, 13% wool, and 9% nylon. Then I found the yarn from the Norwegian company called Rauma, I don't know how to say it, chuk mohair. And that's also, yeah, mohair, wool, and 5% polyamide. Oh, I don't know how to say that in English. Polyamide, maybe it's the same, yeah. But so it's not much, but it's still not 100% natural. But it's quite a lovely yarn anyway. Yes, so you can use that for the for these patterns too. And they are in a lot of really nice colors. So many people so much want to knit this, exactly this. And I have found they have the a light blue that could do. The yellow is not as bright as the one from Touch. It's quite different actually. And I've used this sunny thing from Touch for, you know, like a signature. Like I have this small, just one round or two rounds stripe down here. That's, yeah, I just like that. But they have a yellow and they have a pink and they have really lovely colors. My sister have done a scrap vest, but where she have used the same color of mohair all the way, and then she has changed the following thread, like using scraps of sock yarns, and that makes a totally different outcome like this. It's quite lovely, yeah. And actually, I have made a vest, a scrappy cardigan, a scrappy cardi the same way. This one. And it's here. And it's actually made like the same way as the scrap vest. It's the rips are done at needle 6.5 millimeters and the body, as well as here in the Scrappy Cardi, as well as the vest, is on 8 millimeter needles. Yeah. Here I have used the gray, this from Touch Yarns called Silver, together with a really, oh, where is that? Here. Then I bought a ball of really, you know, old fashioned sock yarn, this gray one. It's 100 grams. Yeah. And then I held these two together when I have done the ribbing, because then it gets more like calm, the output or the outcome, or yeah, it's like it's more calm as I did in the vest. I always see that I have enough of my the color that I use, this light one or the gray one, but so I have enough for the ribbing. Maybe I said that before, but and maybe for a stripe in between, because then it makes the outcome more like calm. It just, it brings it all together. I don't know how to explain that. And I've done that too in my Scrappy Cardi. It's a chunky one, like, I'll do like this. Can I do like this? Yes. There is no buttons or buttonholes or anything. You could do like this and put a needle or whatever in this to keep it closed. But it's meant like being a jacket, a loose one, a chunky one. And the Scrappy Cardi, as well as the scrap vest, is in one size. Sorry that I'm jumping, you know, back and forth, but the scrap vest is like 130 centimeters over here, over the breast, and then you can make it shorter or longer as you wish. But always remember to, if you want to change the, as I made it, make it longer, do it before you split the work, before you make the armholes, and be aware that you think about it when you get up here and before you make the neckline, then you have to knit that longer too. And the scrap vest, Scrappy Cardi, sorry. It's one size two. It has quite long sleeves because I have really long arms. You can make them shorter, or you can, you know, it's a chunky ribbing, so you can make it like this. I don't know what's that called when you do this. When I knit this, I will show you. I do, as I said before, the rib on needle 6.5 millimeter, and when I get up and do the stockinette stitches here in the body, I change to 8 millimeter needles, also in the ribbing up here. You can't see that, so that's fine. And then the stripes, as you see here, it's only in the body, it's not in the ribbing here. I keep on knit the front edges with one strand of the gray one in mohair and one strand of the gray sock yarn. And therefore I do, I make an extra ball so I can have that, you know, for each front edge. And that means, the mohair, I use that all the way back and forward all the way. But when I get to the, when I've made the ribbing, I have actually tried to make a test here. When I knit the ribbing, the front edge rib, and get to the point where I'm going to knit the stockinette stitches, I will continue using my gray mohair. But the sock yarn, the gray sock yarn, I will change and use some colored yarn. It's really bad that I haven't chosen a more bright color so you could see that. And when I do that, I take, this is the sock yarn I've just been using. And I always, the strand that I'm going to use now, I put underneath the one I just used. So I just twist it just once, just a little bit, and then I can continue in stockinette stitches. And when I've made just two stitches, I just pull, just not too tight, but just pull the yarn I just used before for the ribbing, because then it just tighten up. And I think I can show you here. Just a moment here, because then it just makes such a fine, it's just, you know, it's a fine, it just looks good. It's nice. And no holes or no loose ends or loops or anything. So that's just a little advice. How much yarn do I use? For this Scrappy Cardi, I use 4 of these. So that's 100 grams each. So 4 of these, and then a lot of scraps. I can't say how much. It's just so it's, going on with this. For my vest, I use for the, ground color, or, you know, of the color that's used in the ribbings, I use 1, then you have to buy 2 balls of this actually, because it's 100 grams. The colors you need. So it's hard to say, because if you use scraps, but for the ribbing you need to, if you don't want this high neckline that uses a lot of, takes a lot of yarn actually, if you do a, you know, more traditional neckline that just a rip, a short rip, you can maybe actually you only need one, but I would buy two because then you have enough for playing with the colors and can make some stripes in this color too. As I said before, it makes the outcome more calm. If you use the Rauma, I don't know, then it's 50 grams and 100 meter. So you need like four of the color that you need to the ribs and a few stripes. And then you can choose like all the colors you want, but you need at least four colors to have enough yarn for a vest. So like three or four of these, depending on how long you want it. So then I think four, and then four colors. So that's 8 bolts of yarn. And maybe you can combine with some scraps. Yes. Is there anything else to say? No, I don't think so. Well, so that was the scrap vest and the Scrappy Cardi. You can buy the patterns on Ravelry, and you can buy the patterns on my website. And my patterns are both in English and in Danish. I have worked a bit on getting them translated to German, but that has been just a bit hard to find anyone who could do that. And I can't, check it out because I don't do the German very well. So, but until now, in Danish and in English and on Ravelry and on my webshop. And it has been quite an adventure to make this scrap vest, because one thing is that I so much love to be creative, to knit, to work with the colors and the wool. I'm just so obsessed with the wool. It's just, I just love it. That's really what I'm passionate about. But when I do these designs and the patterns and they work and people like the patterns and make these scrap vests in so many versions and colors, and are happy with them, and they are, say, it's their favorite, vest or favorite sweater, whatever. It just makes me so happy. I just get so happy. It's like an adventure in itself. So that's wonderful. Yeah. Maybe I should show you this just here before I end this episode. This is a scrap vest where I've used like the touch yarns, but I've also used some scraps from Cowgirl Blues. These are for sale. I do not knit models for sale very often because I don't have the time and I don't want to just knit the same all the time. That's not funny. But these scrap vests has been quite great fun for me to knit. I think it's funny to play with the colors and the stripes, so therefore I have these two for sale at the moment, yeah. But if you see this episode, today is the, we are in March 2023, but these videos last forever, so if you see this in 2025, they might not be for sale anymore, I hope not. But the patterns are always there. They will last forever. Yes. So thank you very much. And I hope that you you got inspired and there was something that you could use. And I hope I might have made you a bit curious. So you want to see some of the other episodes I'm going to make. I'm going to make episodes of right now I dream of doing episodes of every design I've made, so I can tell you about where I got the yarn, because all my designs, they are from my knitting trips and have a story. So I will do a lot of episodes about a lot of my designs, and I will also do episodes about me and my trips to New Zealand and to Ireland. So hopefully you I've made you curious, so you want to watch the other episodes of my vlog or podcast or whatever it's called. Yeah. So thank you very much. I hope you see you soon. Bye bye.
Salt air and the rust on your door. I never needed anything more. Or whispers of, are you sure? Never have I ever.